6 main types of bacteria and viruses that cause food poisoning, their symptoms and how to prevent them. According to Food Safety Information Center, bacteria and viruses are the most common cause of food poisoning. The symptoms and severity of food poisoning vary, depending on which bacteria or virus has contaminated the food. The bacteria and viruses that cause the most illnesses, hospitalizations, and deaths in the United States are Salmonella, Norovirus, Norwalk virus, Campylobacter, E. coli, Listeria, Clostridium perfringens, E. coli enteritis. The black sheep of the food poisoning world, E. coli is the one with a strain that will actually kill you regardless of treatment attempts. The culprits, Escherichia coli, is found in mass-processed ground beef and on vegetables that were improperly cleaned or handled by contaminated fingers. Symptoms. It feels as if you've been stabbed in the colon, which would explain the crippling cramps and other things that might happen if one were actually stabbed in the colon, including blood. Not that there's a better food poisoning to get, but this is one you really want to avoid. Listeria. The range of Listeria infection, or listeriosis, lands you somewhere between asymptomatic and dead and can occur from eating or drinking basically anything that was grown, raised or milked. The culprits, raw or improperly pasteurized dairy products, vegetables grown in contaminated soil, yup, it can live in soil, preserved and smoked meats can be identified by a slippery or slimy film, canned and raw seafood and fresh fruit. Symptoms. A bad flu, although more serious complications like meningitis can occur in people with weakened immune systems, as well as in young children, pregnant women and the elderly. Staphylococcus. This is the picnic food poisoning everyone warns you about, especially you, dude who brought the mayo-choked potato salad. The culprits, the bacteria releases its toxins at the comfy incubator that is room-temperature food, which gives staph food poisoning its signature cookout-ruining reputation. The worst part? Reheating contaminated food won't kill it off. Actually, the worst part is the symptoms. How it feels like. Explosive, and not in a romantic feelings kind of way. Within an hour of ingesting contaminated food, both ends will be entirely occupied for up to a day. The good news is, once it's out and you can get right back to the picnic. Salmonella. The bacteria that causes salmonellosis, or salmonella poisoning, has a serious reputation among poultry and their handlers, and boy does it love hanging out on the stretches of counter you missed with the sanitizer. The culprits, although eggs, processed chicken parts and other raw meat are particularly good at spreading the bacteria, pet reptiles and rodents are also carriers. Wash everything any dead or live animal comes in contact with and maybe don't allow live animals in the kitchen while you're cooking, period. Symptoms. Your small intestine betraying you entirely. Expect a week or so of your typical diarrhea, abdominal cramps and possibly a fever. Shigellosis. Similar to Salmonella but yet so very different as Shigella, which attacks the large intestine rather than the small. The culprit, human waste. While plenty of foodborne illness can be spread this way, particularly by catching a ride in food or water, many cases of Shigellosis can be directly attributed to contact with human waste. It can also be resistant to antibiotics, so definitely practice safe sewage wading. Campylobacter Enteritis. A common bacterial infection producing severe gastrointestinal upset that can hang around as long as 2 weeks. It's rarely fatal in healthy people. It is caused by improperly slaughtered or processed meat not thoroughly cooked, contaminated vegetables, milk or water. Pets can also shed the bacteria. If you love this video, please like and share your opinion in the comment box below. Don't forget to click the subscribe button below for more research-based home remedies and natural health tips.